و سرود ایران رو میخوندن. ما این دو رو تا میدان بهارستان رسوند.
His enemy, they made a drastic mistake by killing him. He became a hero of Iranian struggle. He was a sick man, he could go anyway. But they made a mistake. And the way that they killed him was very brutal and humane. He killed him in a very, very barbaric way. He and his wife. There is no logic to justify, there is no way to justify that kind of killing. Only that reflects how deeply they were opposing him. They couldn't tolerate him.
In the following weeks, there were more murder victims. The writers Pouyandé and Motari, a secret death squad, was apparently trying to paralyze the reform movement through fear tactics.
Ten days after the murder, our parents' home was returned to us. The looting, they had gone through everything that was... They removed all political documents. They practically erased my parents' entire life from the house. It was as if they had completely confiscated the lives of my parents. And in such a disrespectful way. I went through the house, and the whole time I kept asking the security officer who was there, why? What was this all about? What was it supposed to achieve? And he couldn't even look me in the face, just kept repeating, we didn't do this. I'm only responsible for handing it over. This was not our doing.
Das waren wir nicht. Ich bin nur für die Übergabe zuständig. Das waren wir nicht.
No one in Iran really expected the series of murders to be investigated. But then something totally unexpected happened.
Through her house was bugged by the Ministry of Intelligence and Security and other organizations. The guy who came in the morning to change the tape and put new tape picked up the tape from last night and listened. And he heard that they are shouting, fighting, and he realized they are killing Furuhar and his wife.
And it just so happened that the wiretapping expert was not a conservative, but a supporter of the newly elected reform president, Hatami.
He took this cassette, copied the cassette and took it to Hatami's office and told them this is the story. Hatami listened to the tape and his... National Security Advisor Mr. Ali Rabi'i, he also heard, and they summoned Mr. Kazemi, the second man in the ministry, third man in the ministry. And Kazemi confessed. Kazemi said, we did it under the instruction of minister. And we thought we are going to be, you know, greeted with promotion and welcome and so and so.
I have to give the credit to Mr. Khatami. He was the president. He was informed. He had the information that the Ministry of Information, Intelligence Service, has done it. He had either two choices. Either he himself come announce, or back door, beyond the door, push the ministry to come and say, yes, we have done it.
A few weeks after the murder, President Hatami addressed the public himself.
تجنس رو، خشونت رو از هر کس باشه محکوم.
He succeeded in that line, that the Ministry of Information, the intelligence, announced, accepted the responsibility, and said, yes, we have done it. And said, that said, a group of the employees, agents, have done it independently.
In the spring of 1999, a few of the actual perpetrators were arrested. Their interrogations are recorded on a videotape that was smuggled out. Pressure was put on the captives using threats, blows, and wild sexual rumors and accusations. They are to claim the murders were organized by American and Israeli secret agents in an effort to discredit the Islamic Republic. The most important of the accused criminals dies in jail, supposedly by drinking a depilatory lotion. His incriminating statements are subsequently struck from the official record. In his place, his widow is arrested and beaten until she makes new confessions. Ultimately, the process was transferred to the military prosecutor, which meant it was no longer subject to civil or official control. The families of the victims refused to participate in the farce of a secret court case.
The people who actually inflicted those stab wounds on my parents and the person who had strangled the writers, these people were sentenced to death in accordance with Islamic law. That means blood for blood. Retaliatory execution was their punishment, death payment. But the court said that the victim's family members must make the final decision. That means they conducted a court case we did not recognize or agree with. But then they put the burden of judgment in this case on our shoulders. We are now responsible for saying whether we demand the death penalty for people who were really just henchmen. We had to reach that decision.
And yet, according to the sentence, there was a catch to the execution of her mother's murderers. Because under Islamic law, the life of a woman is only worth half as much as that of a man.
The immediate family members may, after paying half of the blood money to the family of this man, demand a death sentence.
Blood money, for the price difference between the life of a man and a woman, demanded by an archaic law that was written prior to the year 1400 and hardly modernized since.
What kind of a system is that? Where the life of my mother, who fought for democracy her entire life, such a wonderful, upstanding woman, a lovable and loving human being, is only worth half as much as that of the man who murdered her. What kind of a value system is that?
آنچه مسلمه قاتلین اصلی معرفی نشدند. یه عده شاید دست دوم دست دوم نمیدونم معرفی شدند و دادگستری هم اعلام کرده که این پرونده دیگه مختوم است، ولی